Welcome to Ben's BQ. Today we will cooking a Boston butt, and this one is from the Shared Foods brand. So stay tuned. Fire up the cube to 110 degrees Celsius. Take off the foil. Make it a little bit dry. And it goes on the cube. We have some cherry wood on it for the smoke. And of course, we're using a digital temp. Now we have to wait a few hours. And in the meantime, that we are waiting, we will show you how we have prepared last night this beautiful piece of meat. As you can see before, we are cooking a Boston butt. This is a whole Boston butt and it weighs around 6 kilograms. And we're using this for the pulled pork. When we look at the meat, there's a fat cap on the top. That's normally by a Boston butt. When you think it's too thick, you can trim it a little bit. Of course, you can remove all the fat, but I like it when you have some fat on a Boston butt. And because our Boston butt has a layer of fat, it's important that you have to cut it crosswise. Then we will brine the meat. Our brine consists of 3 cups apple juice, 3 cups apple cider, 2 tablespoons of honey, and 2 teaspoons Worcester sauce. This brine will ensure flavor in the middle. So make sure that you hit all the meat. And after brining, we are seasoning our Boston butt. Today we are using a pulled pork rub. But of course, you can use your own favorite rub. Sprinkle it over the meat and rub it well. And rub the Boston butt on both sides. Then we will wrap it up and let it stay overnight. We are now 5 hours later. And it's time to give our Boston butt a glaze. I have a sweet smoky barbecue sauce. We cook further for 2 hours on the same temperature. This glaze will give you a lovely bark on the Boston butt. We are now 2 hours later. And look at that bark. Isn't it gorgeous? It's time to pick up our Boston butt and we wrap it up in some tin foil. Now we place it back to the pit because we want a core temperature of 88 degrees Celsius. And when we have reached a core temperature of 88 degrees, we will check out our Boston butt. The Boston butt is really soft. Now we wrap it up in tin foil and let it rest for 1 hour.
This is awesome. Oh. The juices. And of course, you'll taste. This is good. I love this. For the pulled pork, we make an end sauce. We're using barbecue sauce and the juices of the meat. I'll do it over the pulled pork. Then we mix it a little bit. And of course, we will taste. This tastes amazing. I will say thanks for watching. I hope to see you next time. If you like the video, give a big thumb up. And see you next time. Until Ben's BBQ.